Chess friends, how are you? Magnus Carlsen is a Norwegian chess grandmaster, who is the goat of every chess players, but can he defeat me in chess? I don't think so, but I will give him a chance to defeat me, and this is your today's puzzle, 120 IQ chess puzzle, solve it and comment me, I will share you the puzzle answer at the end of the video. Life isn't about finding yourself, life is about creating yourself, so let's go. I started the game with f4, which is called bird's opening. The computer suggests playing knight f3 and e3 as white's next moves. Black often plays e5 to open the dark square diagonal, but this will help me to open up the f-file for my rook. In this bird opening I will play bishop fumetto in queenside. Magnus played Dutch opening d5, e3 and knight f3 are the top line as I told you. 69 LO rated player will think of playing g3, but that isn't the good move as black can push forward his h-pawn, so we have e3 c5, Magnus might consider a6 or g6 to play the bishop fumetto in his next move, so I played b3 first, knight f6 and we have bishop b5, we have bishop exchanges on d7 square, knight f3 e6 and I played castle. Try to understand my strategy here, I played castle by making pawn chain, it protects from the dark square bishop lines. It is called pawn unity, which protects your weak square, so Magnus played bishop e6, get this dark diagonal, bishop b2 castle and I played c4, this f4 and c4 move reminds me the old days chess games. When we strive to become better than we are, everything around us becomes better too, so Magnus pushed his cop, e takes d4 and exchanging the pawns isn't good. There is knight takes d4 and white will get tiny amount of advantages, but it will damage your position, which you can't see now. White will consider these moves to create problems for the black structure and the center position. So in this position, Magnus decided to take the pawn. We have g3 bishop, back to h6. He wants to have control over this diagonal. D takes pawn, knight takes pawn, bishop a3, to pin the knight to the rook. What black should play? If you think queen c7 might protect the knight, but what about d4? Now you has to run with your knight, then you will lose the rook on f8, rook takes f8 and I will get a rook for my bishop. Eval bar isn't much high for white, but I always used to say that, if you are a human, then never believe in evaluation bar. So back to the position, Magnus here decided to play knight d3, sacrificing the rook away, because black is creating little amount of threats for my king by the knight and queen. I do not fear of him because I defeated Magnus Carlsen more than 100 times. A fool always thinks that he is an intelligent person, while an intelligent person thinks that he is a fool. I captured the fool Magnus Carlsen rook, queen takes bishop, king h1, try to get rid from this check, so after queen c5 queen e2, I am threatening to take the knight, so we have rook d8, knight c3 g6, to settle the bishop in a good looking post. So here I decided to sacrifice my knight on d5, the knight can be captured by the pawn or knight, but the worst thing is that you can't even touch my knight. If you take it with your pawn, then I will capture the knight on d3, the pawn is pinned to the rook, rook e1 is coming, I would get two rooks and win the game outright. So back to the position, my knight is threatening to capture your knight, so if you dare to take the knight, then I will capture your d3 knight anyway. Your knight will be under attack, and if you try to save it from miseries, then I will capture your rook. Position will be very bad for you, so in this position, we have knight g4 to making a threat on f2 square, so I played queen takes d3, any normal player will think of playing e takes d5, but that is not beneficial at all, so Magnus tried to create pressure with his bishop, there's no problem that Stockfish can't solve, so I played h3 to kick out the knight. If you move back your knight, then I will simply play queen e3, the knight and the rook is under attack, but the real thing is that, your queen is in danger, if you take it then I will take back it with knight, so after few moves later, I will get one extra piece which will lead to winning the game. So back to the position, Magnus decided to take the rook, and we have big exchanges on the board, we are entering the end game with queen rook and knight variation, king g2 takes takes, have you noticed? I have extra piece and I am totally winning the game. I will give you the answer to the puzzle that I gave you at the beginning of the game after checkmating the black. Okay, fine, this is your today's puzzle, try to solve it. Any normal player will think of playing knight takes pawn, but that isn't the best move. How will you checkmate the white king? Okay, if you find bishop g1, then congratulations, you are correct. Checkmate is coming there, so white has to take the bishop, queen h2 check king here. Now what should black play now, because everything is secured? If you find e5, then you are absolutely right. If you didn't, then don't worry, I will give you another chance. Takes, black sacrifices the knight, takes knight takes e5 check, the king is forced to go f4 square, knight g6 check king backs. Now tell me here, what should black play now? 1 2 3 4 5, if you find f4, then you are correct again. So many things can be happen in a same time, let me show you the variations one by one. If you take the knight with bishop, then we will play bishop a check takes takes, king h5 takes takes, and after 3 moves later, it will be a checkmate. So back to the position, if you take the pawn, then we will play knight e5 check, and look at the king has no squares, that means that game will be over, so in this position black have to take it with e-pawn. Bishop g4 check to target the queen, takes knight e5 check, the king have no square left to hoe, so you have to take it, and now, h5, checkmate. So wish you all the best, thanks for watching, subscribe for more, bye bye, take care, see you soon.